Plus, I hope you are safe at your home, right? Okay, today we will discuss about the microspore, formation of microspore and development of microspore. Yesterday we had discussed about the anther wall, which is made up of the sporogenous cell and which is formed by the archisporial cell actually. So the sporogenous cell, all the microspore cells actually have capability to develop into the microspores or pollen grain, but in a few microspore cells become degenerate and the remaining start to increase their size and increase the cytoplasm for developing the pollen grains or microspores. Simply you can say that the sporogenous cell actually is surrounded by the anther wall. Anther wall is present around the these sporogenous cells, and out of these sporogenous cells, a few cells start to increase their size. It's called the microspore mother cell actually, and these microspore mother cell have capability of division meiotically simply. It means the microspore mother cell divide meiotically, and after each meiotic division, the microspore mother cell is converted into the four pollen grains or microspores. Simply you can say that, right? During the microsporogenesis, what is the meaning of microsporogenesis? Means the formation of pollen grain and the formation of microspores. Simply you can say that. Right, and these microspore actually formed by the microspore mother cell. When the microspore mother cell start the meiotic division and increase their size and the content of the cytoplasm, this first cell is called the primary microsporogenous cells. And these division in the microspore mother cell is a successive type of division. What is the meaning of successive type? It means firstly the nucleus is divided, then the cytoplasm of the cell is divided and the new cells are formed actually. Similarly, in case of the microspore mother cell or the primary microsporogenous cells, which is arise from the first division, show the successive division. Firstly, the nucleus enlarges and divided, and then the cytoplasm content enlarges, increase and divide into the various daughter cell. From the one microspore mother cell, actually the four daughter cell has arisen. And these four daughter cells actually arrange in a different manner in the different organism, or in different species have different kind of arrangement of these daughter cell. For example, first is a tetrahedral. In this structure, the three microspores actually arrange in the front side or in the upper side, and the one daughter cell is behind these three cells. This kind of structure is called the tetrahedral type of structure. In most of the dicotyledons plant, this type of microspores are formed actually. Next is the isobilateral. In that condition, all the four daughter cells are in front side. All the four microspores are present in the same side, and most of the monopore, this kind of division of microspores occur. Next is the decussate type. In that kind of division, two microspores are perpendicular to each other. For example, these two are the vertical to each other, perpendicular to each other, which is front side, and one is in the transfer. Two microspores are transferred to each other. One is in front and one is from its back side, is called the decussate type. And next is the T shape. In T shape, two microspores show longitudinal division and two show the transfer division. So these fours are arranged in that manner. And one more is the linear. In that condition, all are divided in the linear manner in a same line. Simply, all microspores are present in a linear form. So these are different type of the arrangement of the microspore after the formation of meiotic division from the microspore mother cell. From the microspore mother cell, they are formed are diploid. Actually, the microspore mother cell is diploid in nature because they have diploid 2n number of chromosomes, it means. But after the meiotic division, all the microspore, all the four daughter cells, or all the four pollen grains have half number of chromosome because of the reductional division. Because in case of microspore mother cell, reductional division takes place and it reduces the number of content of the chromosome in case of all these microspores. Right. Next is the dicels. After the formation of this, okay, one more thing. This wall is made up of cellulose in case of microspore. Right now here they are not separated, they are bounded. They all four microspore are attached with each other and their wall is made up of cellulose. One enzyme is there is called cellulose. Their wall is made up of callose and there is an enzyme is called callase. These callase enzyme actually separate these wall of four microspore. After this activity of this enzyme, the wall of the these microspores are separated. It means all pollen grains are survived individually. They are not present in a compact manner of four, not in togetherly they are survived, simply you can say that they are separated from each other with the help of an enzyme callase, we can say that. But in few cases, for example in callotropis, these pollen grains are present together or in a bundle, is called pollinia. Right, in few cases, if two or more microspores are attached to each other, that microspores are called polyspory actually. But most of the cases, these microspores actually separated out. Their walls are separated with the help of an enzyme callase simply. After the separation or after the maturation, the next step is the dehiscence. You know that the dehiscence, after the maturation, the pollen grains are split out from the anther and go into their target site. That process is actually called dehiscence. Dehiscence actually occur in the endothecium with the help of endothecium layer. Yesterday we had discussed about the endothecium layer, which is made up of cellulose and hygroscopic in nature, which provide moisture to the pollen grain. At the opposite side of endothecium, there is a point is called a stomium. This stomium point actually thin in structure as compared to the entire endothecium. So firstly, it start dry up after the maturation of pollen grain. When it start dry up, it become burst and the dehiscence means the spreading of the pollen grain takes place. But it also of a different kind in different species, simply you can say that. First is the transverse type. It means the stomium is burst in the transverse section like this. Next is a longitudinal, if it burst like longitudinally. Next is a poricidal. It means the pores with the help of various pores are formed. Through the pores, the pollen grains comes out. Volvular, it means the wall this is your anther. One valve is split out and the pollen grains are comes out. In transfer division, this is your anther, this longitudinal, this. This is your anther, pores are formed and through the pores the pollen grains comes out. So in different species there are different mode of dehiscence, simply you can say that. So these are the different methods of dehiscence which occur in the angiospermic plant. Next is where the male gametophyte. What is the male gametophyte and how it is made actually? Male gametophyte is formed by the process of gametogenesis. We know that the formation of gamete is called gametogenesis. So male gamete is actually formed by the gametogenesis. We had already reduced the number of chromosome in the microspore, right? During the male gametophyte, it means there is no meiotic division takes place, only the mitotic division takes place. When the development of male gametophyte takes place, there is the mitotic division takes place in these microspores. And after the mitotic division, their nucleus is divided. Their nucleus is divided into two different cells, is the generative cell, which is a small and flat structure, and large is the vegetative cell. These are the two different size of cells which is formed by the mitotic division in the microspore, right? And the cytoplasm content start increase, become dense, simply you can say that, during the male gametophyte, because the cytoplasm require at the time of division. So cytoplasm become dense and the nucleus is divided into two different cells. The first is the small generative and large is the vegetative cell, right? and next is the structure of pollen grain. Firstly, we will discuss about the structure. After this, I will explain more what the role of generative and vegetative. Firstly, what is the structure of pollen grain? Pollen grain have two membrane. One is the exine, outer is the exine membrane, and inner is the intine membrane. Right? Exine membrane is made up of a substance, a hard substance is called sporopollenin. This is the substance which make the exine more hard and resistant to the moisture and any other substance and any other organic and inorganic substance. Because of this sporopollenin, the pollen grains become survive for the long time because the sporopollenin does not degrade into the environment. Simply you can say that degradation is not possible because it is resistant to water, waterproof. You can say that the exine membrane of the pollen grain is a waterproof and there is no degradation possible of the exine, so that the pollen grain can easily survive in the nature. One more thing about the exine is that exine membrane consists of one or two or hardly three area where the sporopollenin is absent. For example, this is the sporopollenin of the pollen grain. There is one point where the sporopollenin is absent. That point is called germ pore actually. Through this point actually the intine membrane comes out and the pollen grains is the pollen tube is formed in case of the angiospermic plant simply. So here the point is called the germ pore where the sporopollenin is absent. In most of the cases there is one, in few cases there is two, and there are few cases also there which have three germ pores are present. It means maximum 1 to 3 germ pores are present in the exine of any pollen grain. Next is the intine. Intine is present inner side of the exine, which is the smooth and made up of lipid, protein, these substances are made present in the intine membrane and it easily can burst up by the endosmosis. I will tell you about the endosmosis, what is the meaning here about the endosmosis. So this is the structure of the pollen grain. And one important thing about the pollen kit we had discussed yesterday, which is formed by the Ubish body, and this pollen kit actually attract the insect because of the smell and make the pollen grain sticky, so it can easily attach with the insect in case of the cross pollination, as well as the it is sticky, that's why it easily stick over the stigma of the female gametophyte, right? This is the structure of pollen grain actually, right? Now we will discuss the development and formation on the basis of generative and vegetative cell. Listen, the development of male gametophyte, how it is occurred. In most of the angiosperm, in 60% you can say that 60% angiosperm, the complete development of male gametophyte actually occur on the stigma, after the reaching the stigma of the female gametophyte. 60% angiosperm of pollen grain actually exist in 2 cell stage only, and 40% angiosperm can develop before the fertilization, and it divided into 3 cell stage actually. But in 60% only 2 cell stage pollen grain is survived, right? During the development of male gametophyte, what will happen? These 2 cells are present in the microspore, and their cytoplasm is not separated, their wall is not separated. Wall is not separated in case of both these generative and vegetative cells. Before the development, the generative cell actually attach with the wall of the microspore. After the development or during the development, this generative cell separate out from the cell wall and enter into the cytoplasm of the vegetative cell, because vegetative cell have more cytoplasm, right? So it float into the cytoplasm of the vegetative cell because it does not have more cytoplasm. It has a very small amount of cytoplasm only. It is a small structure, flat structure, and a rounded in shape, a fixed structure. But the vegetative cell is not fixed in shape. It is large in size as compared to this, more cytoplasm, and the nucleus is large as compared to the generative cell, right? Now the how this develop it this is the development of generative and enter into the vegetative cell. Next I will tell you about the nucleus content of the generative and vegetative. Generative and vegetative both have same kind of content, you can say that it has more vacuoles and more cytoplasm and organelles, but during their development the protein become disappear because it is not required of protein in the case of generative vegetative cell. And in case of generative there is no vacuole because it is a very small cytoplasm and small in size, flat in structure, and both have same kind of nuclear content, DNA and RNA, but vegetative have more RNA as compared to the DNA. It has more RNA, it has more DNA content because the male gamete actually formed by the generative cell. During the formation of male gamete, what will happen? This vegetative cell is actually present here, right? And when this your pollen grain is goes to the stigma of the style, stigma of the female gamete, then what will happen? It absorbs the stigma fluid from here because there is no pollen sporopollenate. After the endosmosis, it becomes swell-up. It becomes swell-up, then the intine bursts up. When it bursts up, because the area is very, lumen is very small, so intine comes out in the form of tube. This tube is actually called the pollen tube, right? Actually the pollen tube, why it is formed? Because the area of germ pore is very small. Similarly, this vegetative cell actually help for the formation of this pollen tube, migrate the pollen tube where it need to go, and the generative cell start the mitotic division, and this generative cell divide into the two divide into the mitotic division and form two male gametes. So there are two male gametes are formed from the generative cell, and vegetative cell actually help in the formation of pollen tube. These two generative cell or these two male gametes which are formed by the generative cell actually fertilize the egg. One fertilize the egg which form the zygote and embryo, and another male gamete fertilize with the polar cell which form the endosperm or which provide the nourishment to the young one embryo till the root and shoot has arise from the seed, simply you can say that. So there are two in case of angiosperm, two times fertilization takes place. One male gamete fertilize with the egg and another male gamete fertilize with the polar cell or form the endosperm. So that kind of fertilization is called double fertilization. In detail we will discuss about the double fertilization. I will just tell you there are two male gametes present formed by the generative cell. So in maximum 60% angiosperm, only two cells are present before the fertilization, but in remaining 40%, the generative cells divide before the fertilization into the two male gametes. So there are three cells are present, three cell stage. But in 60%, there are two cell stage, and this generative cell actually divide after the reaching the stigma of the female gametophyte, right? So this is all about the male gametophyte development, formation, and the structure all, right? Tomorrow we will discuss about the female gametophyte or megasporophyte. Thank you.